Hey guys, welcome back to another video on the High Mountain Homestead. Today I'm talking about all the tips and things that I've learned about how to raise sheep in the winter time. I'm going over food, water, shelter, and a few of the tips that I've been able to learn. If you are new to the channel, welcome. We talk about sheep a lot, but we also got chicken. I almost just tripped on this ewe. We got chickens, rabbits. We're no-till, regenerative farming operation. If any of that's up your alley, hit the subscribe button. But today, let's just start talking about sheep in the wintertime. Okay, let's start with the easy stuff, shall we? Water. Make sure it's not frozen, okay? So at our operation, I give them about 5 gallons a day. And if this looks a little brown, it's because I've got a tip for you. Because they expend so much energy in the winter time, just staying warm, I give them once a week, I give them just a little bit of blackstrap molasses in their water. I think it makes them more thirsty. Maybe not more thirsty, it makes the water taste better for sure. And they go for it. So that makes me really, really happy to make sure that they're hydrated. So I just topped them off with that yesterday, I want to say. So that's why it's a little bit dark. But by the end of the week, it looks like regular water because they're drinking and I'm adding about 5 gallons a day to it. You can get a de-icer. I'm just too lazy to run a cord all the way out here because all of our extension cords are being used on Christmas lights outside. So when Christmas time is over, I'll probably get a de-icer out here. Okay, now let's start talking about food. So we are a grass-fed operation here. So what does that actually look like in the winter time? Well, it means we're putting out hay for them, okay? And so I feed them twice a day. I don't really measure the hay in pounds. I kind of tell myself if I'm going through one bale every 5 days or every 4 days, I'm pretty happy with both them and myself as far as rationing it and making sure that they're taken care of. So our hay is alfalfa, and it is a mountain-grown alfalfa hay, which is useful because mountain-grown alfalfa has a higher protein count. So if you're in the winter time with sheep, chances are your sheep are likely pregnant or near lambing. And so if they're about a month out from lambing, you want to increase their protein intake. And if they are either a month before introducing them to a ram, all the way to a month after removing the ram, hey, guess what? You're going to want to make sure that they've got a high protein feed as well in that kind of scenario. So that's why we use this alfalfa hay right now. Very, very valuable for them in the winter time. Okay, so as you can see, I've got, for a suburban lot, a lot of land right here, right? It's probably about, 3/4 of an acre of just pasture. So why are they on this little run, you might be asking? Well, this is the place where I can guarantee, make sure that they have good shelter in the wintertime. So when there's a lot of snow on the ground, I want to make sure that they have a dry place to go. When it snows and thaws, this can get pretty wet as well as it can out there. It hasn't even thawed out there, right? It thaws here because they've got these wonderful hooves that kind of mash up the ground there. So we have this shelter here. This is just kind of an existing shelter that was here when we bought the property. We use this run, or plan to use this run for pigs for a few months out of the years just to finish some hogs. So that's why it's kind of not really optimized for a rotational system. It's kind of more just a straight hog run. But it's the place where we have shelter. So I like to make sure that they have a windbreak and that it is dry. So you can see out here, it's kind of wet. We still have some grass on the ground, a lot of leaves, a lot of wood chips. We kind of just throw all of our broken sticks and stuff from the trees here. And then when you walk in here, it's like magic. It's so dry. And it's a very good windbreak in here. So I feed them in here to incentivize them to basically want to congregate in here. I used to have their feed way the heck over there, which was great for me because that's where I'm walking from every morning. But then they just congregate out there in the snow. And I know that they're resilient animals, okay? I know that, like, I'm not so much worried about the cold as I am about the dryness of them. So you can see her hooves. For example, are you going to sit still for me, Diana? Of course not. You can see from her hooves, which kind of need to be trimmed, that they're dry, right? And they're not iced on. That's what you want to make sure, that there's no ice, you know, forming on their hooves, because that's obviously painful and bad form for raising sheep. Look at the ram here. He's like, don't look at me, bro. Okay, so rotation, right? So we're 100% grass-fed, aside from the last week of life. If we're butchering them, we'll give them a little bit of rolled oats. But, you know, we're, aside from that little asterisk, we're 100% grass-fed. Hi, sweetheart. You just want to hang out with me? Let's sit down and talk while I'm doing this. So we've got this really great rotational system. Again, we don't have a lot of land, but it does what we need it to do for our purposes. So we move them on and off these two lots here. But in the wintertime, I'm giving them 100% of their feed, right? So I just want to make sure that they have a place that that they can get food, water, and shelter during the winter. So got shelter over here, got food and water over there. If we reach a stretch in the wintertime where I don't have a lot of snow on the ground, I'll move them. You know, I don't mind moving them. It's just I feel bad because my barn that I built for them, I didn't anticipate how much hay I would have to fill that barn with, and I don't really have a divider for them, so they can't really go hide out in there because they'll just snack on hay all day. Which, as much as I like being a nice sheep guy, I don't love them just eating hay because they're bored. Yep, round two. Sheep are so picky about their food. It is so funny to me that they'll like eat and then 15 minutes complain. And when I was new to this, I would go back over there and be like, oh, you poor girls, you must be out of food already. And it's like, oh, it looks like you just moved this food around with your nose. It's like, yeah, pretty much. They're picky. So I've learned to not necessarily respond to the cries and just realize, feed them twice a day, feed them enough food, and they'll go back for more eventually, which is what they're doing. Of course, as I'm getting to something really interesting, my phone dies. So what you can do for a food supplement is, I know you got pumpkins, right? Because we just had this thing called fall. So take a pumpkin, slice it up. These are just pie-sized pumpkins, so I'll just probably cut those in half. The softer the better, but I'm going to treat these ladies and man to some pumpkin tonight. Now, a note on pumpkin is, like, you know, they're not going to like go after it immediately. At least I've never seen that. The ram has been interested in pumpkin before, right up front, this dude right here, but nobody is like crazy about it. So I'm going to put out some pumpkin. I'm not expecting them to like dive into it, but over the next 2 days, they usually consume all of it. And here's the face of a guy who was definitely wrong, because they seem to really be interested in this pumpkin this time. So that's good news. I'm happy to be wrong about them liking pumpkin. Here's the reason why. One, it's free. Who doesn't love free food? But two, it is a natural dewormer for the sheep. So I'm all about natural solutions. You know, I usually do it with what can I think of it? With like a apple cider vinegar solution. So look at them. They are chowing. I love it. Love that. Love that. Hey, one last note. I probably should have talked about it while I was talking about shelter. But if you want to house them in a barn entirely, that is possible. The reason why I don't do it in this barn over here is because while I talk with you, I can't separate the the hay away from them. But even if that wasn't a problem, ventilation is almost almost always the problem with sheep, with chickens, with just about any animal that you house over the winter time, because you know the poop particles get into the air, they start getting too much ammonia in the ground that they're on, and not enough ventilation to pull it away. So you can do it, but err on the side of ventilation. Okay, sheep are sturdy enough; they carry a barn on their back. Okay, so if you are doing it in a barn, I would err on the side of over ventilate because they will take care of the heat themselves. Hey, thanks for sticking around all the way to the end of the video and watching these sheep make me look like a dope when I said that they were not going to go after that pumpkin, and they totally did. Now seems like as good a time as any to end the video. If you keep sheep and you have some tips, I would love to know them. I think the whole channel would love to know them. And if you want to see more of what's going on with sheep and the other fun things we have going on at the High Mountain Homestead, hit the subscribe button, ring the bell, so we can see each other throughout the rest of the year when it's not just wintertime and cold and miserable. So thanks again for stopping by, and I'll catch you on the next video. What's up, dude? How are you doing today? This is our ram. He's not actually ours. He's just on loan right now. He's young, though. He's just like 9 months. But I've already seen him cover a few of the ewes, so we have him for a few more weeks. Look at that confirmation in the face. That is exactly a very masculine ram face.